Hello, this is GeoTechLand, and today I'll be talking about the Linux smartphones that are coming up in the next few months or so here. There's actually two phones on the way here that are running, you know, I guess a GNU / Linux OS, and one of them is the Pine phone, and the other is the Librem 5 phone. So both of those phones are currently being worked on. I think Librem 5 has already started shipping some phones to early adopters, and recently PinePhone has been available for purchase. I'll actually be getting both phones to test and, you know, compare the two, so which is going to be pretty fun. The Librem 5 phone, I did purchase it like a couple months ago, or pre-ordered, I should say. They're being released in several different batches. The batch that I'm going to be on right now is the Evergreen, so it's actually the mass production batch, which I think it's going to be available around March. So I won't be getting one of the early models. Honestly, that's fine with me. It would have been nice to kind of get, you know, an early impressions and review of it, but I guess if I'm paying $700, you know, $650 for a phone, I'm perfectly fine getting the sort of mass production batch where, you know, all the kinks are fixed. So that's exciting. And then the Pine phone, it's been recently available for purchase, and I actually did purchase it. I wasn't sure if I was gonna wait for a different edition of this phone, but from what I read, it looks like this edition will be pretty solid anyway. So, and since the price is very reasonable, I thought I'd pick it up now. Oh my god, Ubuntu, which they do a lot of great work, they put on this little graphic here comparing the two phones. Again, I think one thing to keep in mind, both these phones will be very experimental anyways. So don't think you're getting, you know, a daily driver phone that can replace your current smartphone, whether it's Android or iOS phone at the moment. It's going to take a while. Just like in the, I view this in the early days of Linux, where there's a lot of different flavors, but they weren't very ripe yet. They were still getting a lot of kinks worked out, but eventually they did. And now Linux OSs are better in many ways than Windows and Mac, so I feel like this is just the start here, and there's going to be lots of different OSs, lots of different phones that will, you know, eventually mature and get better. And because they're free and open source, expect the software to be top notch. As to which phone people should get that are curious, then I don't know, I lean towards the Pine phone, you know, especially because of the price. For an experimental phone, I just don't recommend people paying too much for it. But the Librem 5 phone does have, you know, 1 GB more RAM, has a much better camera. Looks like it'll have a nicer screen from what I've read about Prism's screen. They're still both going to be, you know, 720p resolution display, so it's kind of a disappointment. I wanted at least 1080p, but probably won't be too big of a deal if you're going to use your phone for basic stuff especially. And the main thing is they're going to be more privacy focused, so they do have those kill switches, so you can turn off, you know, the camera, microphone, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, cellular. And so that's going to give us a peace of mind when, you know, with family, we want to have a private conversation. We don't want, you know, it to be data mined. So it's going to be fun though, because both of these phones are going to be changing a lot. I feel like even just with these two phones, I'll have plenty of content keeping track with every update, every improvement. It's going to be really fun. And so I can't wait for that. So if you're just as excited about these Linux smartphones as me, you should definitely subscribe, follow me and all the social medias so you can stay up to date on how these phones improve over the months, over the years. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you like, share, subscribe, and I will see y'all next time.